where we stopped last Sunday, the appointed time, this is part two, the appointed time. Tell somebody, this is my appointed time.
This is my
set time for God to favor me.
This is my set time for God to favor me.
Just make that announcement to somebody near you, that this is my time, it is the appointed time for God to favor me. The set time has come. The Bible says in Psalm 102 verse 13, you will arise and have mercy on Zion. For the time to favor her, yes, the set time has come. You will arise and have mercy on Zion. For the time to favor her, yes, the set time has come. I hope you catch this statement, this verse. It is Psalm 102 verse 13. And I think you understand this. In a set time, the Lord will favor Zion. That's what he said. In a set time, he will favor Zion. You are the Zion, because you are the church. Zion is the church. Upon the mountain Zion, here we are to worship God. You are the church. So the Lord will favor Zion. And he said again, the time to favor her, that time, the time for God to favor you is now, it's now, it's here. You take this by faith. I prophesy that this year the Lord will favor you.
Amen.
You take this by faith. You say it, as man thinks in his heart, so it is. Begin to think of God's favor in your life. That God will favor you with protection.
Amen.
He will favor you with increase.
Amen.
He will favor you in every aspect, even comfort, peace, the Lord will favor you.
Amen.
Through God's favor, you will enlarge your goals.
Amen.
And all that you are asking God to do for you, the favor of God will bring those things to your doorstep, the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
See, and that time has come. So what I'm saying is that, yes, the Lord has decided to favor Zion. Which means the Lord had decided to favor you because you are one of his. So he has decided to favor you. But you see, I can tell you, I will give you something. And I may not tell you the time. I may promise you of something, I may not tell you the time. So my promise can come up, or that promising note can be today, can be a year time, can be 10 years time, can be 30 years time. And as woman, I may not even keep my promise. But here God is saying, I will favor Zion. And the time to favor Zion is now. So the time for God to bless you, the time for God to increase every work of your hand, I'm prophesying that it is now.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Lord will favor your family.
Amen.
He will favor this church.
Amen.
The Lord will favor every work of your hand.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
See, that Psalm 90 verse 17 is so good. I love that Psalm. And I told you, keep this psalm for your prayer points this year. Say, let the favor of the Lord our God be upon us.
Amen.
It's God's favor. It's God's favor. What makes the difference between life and death? It's favor. God's favor. It's God is not one is smart or so. It's not that. I was reading the report of the killing at that airport in Florida. And there was a man, I think from Chicago, he was interviewed there in Chicago, and he said the saving grace for him was his laptop. He had the laptop in his backpack. So he was carrying the bag at the back. And when this man shot people, he was killing them execution style. He was aiming at their head. And he was equal employer, or let me say equal murderer. He was not choosing black, white, blue, green, no. He was killing anybody, according to the account. So this man was shot, and when the bullet was to go in, the bullet passed through the bag, and then it was the laptop that stopped it, and the laptop was shattered. That is favor. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The Lord will favor you.
Amen.
You will not die anyhow.
Amen.
Because we have decided to seek the goodness of the Lord in this land of the living, He will take care of us.
Amen.
No evil will come close. close to us.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Say, let the favor of the Lord our God be upon us.
Amen.
And establish the work of our hands upon us. It's only God that can establish the work of your hands. It's only God. It's not how much you can run. It's not how much you can jump. It's not how much you are smart or intelligent. It's only God. He will favor you.
Amen.
Anything you lay your hands upon, you will prosper.
Amen.
It's only God. It's God that can favor the works of one's hand. It's only God. I said, establish the work of our hands. It's only God who can establish the work of your hands. Some will work and work and work, and they have nothing to show for it. Nothing to show for it. Some will labor and labor and labor. They have nothing to show for it. You know, this morning, we took Romans chapter 9 from verse 15 to 19. We took that Bible very, very good. He said, for he says to Moses, I will have mercy on whomever I will have mercy, and I will have compassion on whomever I will have compassion. So then it is not of him who wills, nor of him who runs, but of God who shows mercy. The Lord will show you mercy in the mighty name of Jesus. Smart on the street over there, they are smart, but they have nothing to show for it. Some run around, they run around, they come back and they're nothing. Some walk and walk and walk, and they cannot tell you this is the result, this is what I have done. They cannot tell you. It's God that can show mercy, it's God that can favor you. That when God favors the work of your hands, it can turn five to thousands.
Yes.
When God favors the work of your hands, it can turn two. To thousands. It's God. You will have God's favor over all that you do this year in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
It will favor the work of your hands.
Amen.
The appointed time for God to bless you is now. The Lord will bless you.
Amen.
With increase, He will favor you.
Amen.
He will enlighten your course.
Amen.
The Lord will grant you peace.
Amen.
And I've seen, look at this, say, for the scripture says to Pharaoh, for this very purpose I have raised you up, that I may show my power in you, and that my name may be declared in all the earth. Therefore, he has mercy on whom he wills, and whom he wills he hardens. The Lord will not harden your heart.
Amen.
The Lord will have mercy.
Amen.
He hardened the heart of Pharaoh, and that was for destruction. There are people in this land that their heart is so hardened. When they are doing something bad, you cannot tell them. It's the favor of God that can bring one to the point of understanding. For you to know that nothing in this life worth dying for. Nothing in this life. I've seen people, they work, they don't even have, they cannot even tell you how much they have enjoyed the food. You know, to even enjoy the labor of your hands, it is the favor of God. For you to work, listen to me carefully. For you to work, and you are well paid, or you have something to show for what you have worked for. Now, for you to sit down and enjoy that labor, it is the favor of God. The Lord will grant you favor.
Amen.
You will enjoy the labor of your hands.
Amen.
You will not labor in vain.
Amen.
You will not work and someone else to enjoy.
Amen.
When it is your time to enjoy, to sit back and relax, death will not snatch your heart.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
It will help you. It will fight your cause.
Amen.
The Lord will see you through.
Amen.
It's the Lord. I just pray that you'll be one of those people He has decided to have mercy on.
Amen.
I just pray that God will count you as one of those people He has decided to have mercy on. So let's quickly see definition from dictionary. What is favor? From dictionary. Favor is over generous preferential treatment. Over generous preferential treatment. And an act of kindness beyond what is due or usual. An act of kindness beyond expectation, beyond what is normal. Oh, the Lord will favor you.
Amen.
Beyond normal, He will favor you.
Amen.
Beyond human expectation, He will favor you.
Amen.
And people will ask you, what is going on? What is going on with you? When you enjoy God's favor, and they see the glory of God in your life, they see the beauty of God in your life, they see how much you relax, they see how much you have peace, they see how much you are so comfortable, they see how much they come near you, they see how much they they can enjoy the relationship. Then they ask you, what is going on? It is God's favor. Something, kindness beyond unusual. Kindness beyond expectation. That is favor. That even yourself, you will wonder, do I deserve this? There are so many instances in the Bible you can take. You can take. Are you going to talk of Esther? Are you going to talk of Joseph, Daniel? Or are you going to talk of David? Among his brethren, he was favored. We can see these people, how much God favored them. Are you going to talk of Solomon? How much he was favored. Even in the midst of all the women around him, I mean, he was favored. He was favored. The Lord be favored in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
So for the sake of this sermon, I will define favor this way. Favor is a marvelous blessing from the Lord. Favor of God is one of the best and greatest things you can have upon your life. One of the best. That is the favor of God. One of the best. When God favors you, when you are favored by God, you need not to just run around and run around and run around. He will direct your path.
Amen.
He will order your step.
Amen.
He will lead you to where you need to go. He will lead you beside the still water. He will restore your soul.
Amen.
Favor of God. Favor of God. Leading you where to go. Leading you where to launch your net. Helping you to catch the big fish. Favor of God. Either in business, either in the office, either in your profession. God's favor. Favor is an extraordinary and supernatural touch of God upon your life. Extraordinary supernatural touch of God upon your life. There are instances of people, they will say, oh, they have a sickness. They will diagnose, oh, you got this sickness. Then they will go back. They say, go around this test, go around this test, go around this test. They will go back again. They run the test again for, you know, maybe for opinion, another opinion. So we didn't see it again. We see what we saw now, you know, yesterday or what we saw last month. It's no longer there. And they continue to wonder, what removed this? Why is this happening? Why? See, God can do anything. He can favor you even earthwise. What some people could die of, God alone can favor other people to pass through it without experiencing any death. The Lord can prolong anyone's life by His favor.
Yes.
See, we need God's favor. We desire God's favor. And the appointed time, the set time for God to favor you is now.
Yes.
Just believe God with me. Whatever you desire God to do for you, believe God with me that this is the set time for God to favor you. Either you have an application with government of the country, it is the time for God to favor that application.
Amen.
It is the time for God to favor that petition. God can favor that petition. He can favor it. It's God. He can lead you. See, there are people, you know, when you go for interview, there are some people that if you go before them, you know, if they are going to decide your faith or they are going to decide your issue, they bring to the table all the problems they got at home. And when they see your case or they see someone else's case, they rat that problem. They will bombard that petition or that application with their own problems they got at home. And with annoyance, they may deny. The Lord be favor you.
Amen.
When it is time for your file to be revealed, the Almighty God will grant you favor before whoever is reviewing it.
Amen.
And the result shall be positive.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Lord be favor the work of your hand.
Amen.
Favor of God and His mercy mark your life as special. God's favor and His mercy mark your life as special. You mark your life as special. It's God's favor that can mark your life. His mercy that can mark your life as special. That can make people look at you as extraordinary person. It's God's favor. And if you see the glory of God and the beauty of God in your life, they will ask you a question, what is going on? And you can tell them, this is what God can do. And they can do the same in your life. It causes your entire life and endeavor to be lifted up above the ordinary and stand out clear. Be lifted up above ordinary and stand out clear. The appointed time to experience God is now.
Amen.
The new experience is favor in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
So through God's favor, you enjoy God's mercy. So I want to understand, I want you to understand what you are enjoying every day as God's children. If you are God's children, I want to be one of his children. If you belong to God, every day you have one of the benefits of giving your life to Christ. One of the benefits of being a Christian is to enjoy God's favor and mercy every day.
Amen.
It's every day for life. He said, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. Goodness and mercy will follow you until you are now going to meet the Lord. That's one of those things you enjoy as Christian, as believer. And that's why it is very good for you. Do not toy around with your Christianity. You see, Christianity is not something you can hide. If any man be in Christ, a new creation, all this must pass away, all this must be new. Do not toy around with your Christianity. Amen. If you believe, if you belong to Christ, it's a great thing. It's a great thing to be one of his. Because every day is preparing for you. Every day is providing for you. Every day is making things new in your life. Look at Lamentations chapter 3, verse 22. Lamentations chapter 3, verse 22. It says, through the Lord's mercies, we are not consumed. Through the Lord's mercies, we are not consumed. Because his compassions fail not. See, God's compassion cannot fail. That's why it's good to be a Christian. God's compassion cannot fail. You will not go to where there will be danger at a particular time. Through God's compassion, he will divert you, he will prepare you, he will lead you, he will help you. His compassion never fail. And he said, they are new every morning. God's mercies, God's compassions are new every morning. And when it has to do with keeping this covenant, the Lord is faithful.
Amen.
He said, great is your faithfulness. Look at that adjective, great. The faithfulness of God, you cannot compare to anything.
Amen.
Human beings can disappoint you. In fact, your wife can disappoint you. Your husband can disappoint you. Your children can disappoint you. Your best friend can mislead you, can disappoint you. So don't think that, see, because we are human. Do you understand me now? That's why the people usually say, or the English always say, the human confidence is vanity. If you put your trust in human beings, you need to go and check it out. You are making mistake. But put your trust in God, in that human being. Amen. And then you can enjoy the faithfulness of God. Hallelujah. God decides who to favor and who to enjoy his mercy. May you be counted as one of those in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
See, I need to give you this very short illustration and we're going to bring to end this part. We have to understand when it has to do with God's mercies, when it has to do with God's favor. Generally, when you have something, and it's made available to everybody, yes. But when something is added, that is extraordinary, then we can call that favor. We can call that mercy. And I have a very small story to tell you, for you to understand this very carefully, that God will favor you.
Amen.
With everything you need in life, he will favor you.
Amen.
Employment is common. You can say, oh, I have the same employment with this guy, I have this. But God can favor you and have mercy on you, and it will make your own to be more easier than other. On the same job, the same title. Let's go favor and mercy. So a little boy one day came to his mother. He said, Mama, give me a peanut butter sandwich. I need a peanut butter sandwich. So the mama, his mother prepared peanut butter sandwich. So but when she did that, then the mama put on that peanut butter sandwich a little jelly. So scrub it with a little jelly. And then he said, Mama, I asked you for a peanut butter sandwich and you put jelly on it too. It's like, oh my, this is what I asked you, but you put jelly. Because that costs more, right? Then the mama or his mother asked him, you know what mercy is? You know what it means to favor somebody? Mercy is when God not only gives you what to ask for, but he has a little extra on it too. He gives you more than you deserve. I had an extra. I put jelly. I know you want peanut butter sandwich, but I added. I put extra for you just to favor you. That will favor you this year.
Amen.
to the power that works in us, that Lord be faithful in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
With all good things in this year, you'll be favored.
Amen.
And the appointed time to favor is now.
Amen.
That time, that set time for God to reach out to you beyond your expectation is today, is now, is this year. The mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I will rejoice with you.
Amen.
We shall all jump for joy and celebrate you.
Amen.
We shall celebrate God in your life.
Amen.
Your friends shall jump for joy in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Your joy will not turn to sorrow in Jesus' name. You.
Yeah.
He set time to bring to pass his promises in your life is now.
Yeah.
He will make a way for you when it seems there are no ways.
Yeah.
He will do beyond what your enemy thought it, that can happen to you.
Yeah.
Your enemy will be flabbergasted.
Yeah.
And you see what God is doing in your life.
Yeah.
And you say, wow! The Lord has been good to you.
Yeah.
So you escape this.
Amen.
You will escape every plot of the enemy.
Yeah.
Afternoon, we bless you and worship you because we are good. Great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. We thank you for this opportunity and this privilege to come together as your children, to fellowship together this Sunday, this second Sunday in this January, in the year 2017. We appreciate all that we have done. We commit our lives to you, Father, that the appointed time to favor us. Father, we ask by your mercy and let it be now in the mighty name of Jesus. Favor us, O God.
Amen.
Thank you, blessed Messiah, because you are so faithful. Glory be to your name, O God.
Hallelujah.
In Jesus' mighty name we are praying.
Amen.
Amen.